Hello guys, welcome to a new video where I will talk about the authentication systems of a Python application and Flask. I will show how to authenticate with a basic authentication system and a JWT authentication. For that, I will use the library flask-http-auth. If you're ready, I will just ask you to subscribe to my channel and let's go. This video belongs to a playlist where I built a complete backend with Python and Flask. Let's start with an already created Flask application that has two endpoints, the health check and another one to get all the user's information. I want to secure only the one which returns the user's information. I will start by adding the dependency using pyjwt. And now I will add some methods to check the password in the init.py file, which is the initial root packages. I will hardcode the password in this module, but I should preferably have them stored in a database. I will talk about the database connection in another video. I will start with the basic authentication. The basic authentication consists in sending the username and password for each request. They will be encoded in Base64 and sent in the authorization header. This is one of the simplest authentication methods because it sends practically the credentials visible to anyone. Let's implement it. I added the decorator to verify the password. This decorator will be executed at each request before entering in each endpoint. And now add a decorator to protect the endpoints. Let's verify it. For the health check, where the authentication is not required, I get the 200 HTTP code. But for the user's endpoint, I get an unauthorized error. Let's add now the basic authentication. Now I get my content. Great, this worked fine. But the basic authentication is basic. It can be easily intercepted in HTTP communications, and the Base64 can be decoded easily. No digest message is needed. So let's change this to the next step, with the token-based authentication, with the JWT. Let's enrich my init module to handle both authentications. and now add the decorator to the desired root. And finally, try it. Here I get my unauthorized error. Let's add now the token. Now I get a 204 HTTP code, which is good. I've added my authorization header with the bearer prefix, as indicated in the configuration of the token, and then the token associated with my user. This authentication method is more secure than the basic one. Why? I can generate tokens randomly with UIDs or hashes, and apply validation times to them. This way, even if a token is intercepted, it will be invalidated soonly. Of course, here I've just hard-coded the token, which isn't good, but I can use a JWT that isn't stored anywhere but generated on the server side. What is a JWT? A JWT is a JSON web token. It's a JSON document that is encrypted with a secret key. First, the user must authenticate itself within a form or with the basic authentication. This will be the only request where the username and password are sent. Then, on the server side, a JSON document will be created with some useful information about the user, like its ID, its name, or some other information. This document will be encrypted with an expiration date. This way, even if the token is intercepted, it won't be used forever. What information can I store in the document? I should store all the necessary information of the user to avoid requests to the database, to avoid storing any information in the session. As the token was generated in the server side with a secret key, it won't be modified by anyone else. I can trust the information stored in this token. Let's see it. I must first add the dependency. And now I will create another route to create the JWT tokens. This will generate a JWT based on the allowed passwords generated before. Now I must update the verify token method to verify the JWT instead of the hard-coded tokens. And now register the previously created blueprint. Let's test it. Here I get my token. Let's now use it. My 204 HTTP code, which means that it logged correctly. Okay, let's recap what I've done. I've added the flask-http-auth dependency. I've implemented the verify password method for the basic authentication, and used the login required decorator on the desired endpoint. I've implemented the verify token method for the token-based authentication. I used the login required decorator on the desired endpoint. I've added the pyjwt dependency. I've added the login endpoint, which generates a JWT with the user information. And I've modified the verify token method to decode the JWT and return the user information. That's all for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If so, click on the like button and subscribe for more videos. Bye!